Hello everyone, this is Direwolf20, and welcome to episode 16 of Direwolf20's Let's Play series. Hooray! I am working on making something that's actually quite similar to something I've already made. And as a result, we're going to probably go through it a lot quicker, because I'm going to expect you guys to have followed along last time I made it, so this time it's going to happen a lot faster. So, don't mind me, I'm just remaking... this contraption, but it's gonna be different. Why? Well, because I want even more power out of my canola seeds. Let's get them to the top tier of canola oil. So remember I mentioned that there's four tiers and we were making the third tier, crystallized? Today we're gonna make empowered. And it's pretty similar to the process that we've already done. So what we're gonna work on today is rearranging a few things. I totally left my Yetta wrench back home, which is a bummer because I thought I had everything I need. But you know what, I realized there's probably one or two things I did forget. So let's get our screwdriver. Let's get our Yetta wrench. Let's get a super circuit maker plate. Yeah, you. Cool. And we're gonna go duplicate what we made last an episode or two ago, where we made the empowered liquid. So to make the top tier of oil is actually pretty easy. Let's get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of you. Awesome. And we're gonna get a stack of you guys. Thank you. This is gonna be crazy awesome. All we need to do in order for the top tier of liquid oil to occur is we need empowered seeds, which we drop one in the stack of these, boom. And we've got these guys. Now, I don't know if we can put full stacks on there or not. I'm thinking you can't. So we're probably gonna want hoppers at some point to figure out how this'll work. But long story short, that is the good stuff, my friends. These are empowered canola seeds, as you can see. They can be used, dropped into crystallized oil, they will turn into empowered oil. So pretty much what I wanna do is duplicate the process that we already made, and the end. It's gonna work. It's gonna be great, and it's gonna be cool. Let's go downstairs and set this whole thing up again. So already, an episode or two back, we made this crazy contraption, which basically guarantees that we always have enough crystallized canola seeds, and we always have the right amount of things. Oh, I forgot an inventory checker. I'm gonna need one of them in a minute. But let's like duplicate this setup, right? So basically we're gonna take our fluid collector and put it here. We're gonna take our fluid placer and put it here. We're gonna take our liquid monitor and put it here, but make sure that it's facing this way with the redstone signal coming out the back. And then we're gonna have our scanner that goes here, okay? And then we're gonna have a block of cobblestone there with a torch on it, like so. And you are in activation mode and you are going to be in pulse mode, okay? This is going to be fluid placer 15%, fluid placer 15%. So we're basically duplicating this setup, right? With more being the setting, more being the setting. Cool. Then we're going to want another one of these gates. So pretty straightforward. I should have all the stuff I need on me. Okay. And then we're going to have redstone all around it. Okay. So we're going to have 1, 2, 3, kind of all these sides all around it. And green and red. So let's get our Yetta wrench here. Green and red. This was green. This side was blue and brown. Okay. And this side can remain red. Cool beans. And then we had a forced into that side with red as well. Click. And then we just need to go up to our inventory checker, which we don't have yet. And we need to have how many blocks above this? 1, 2, 3. Is that cool? That should be good. And we will have our automatic dropper going here, which will also be configured to a redstone pulse. Okay. This is going to be I've still got my backpack on. I'm like, why is my cobble being voided? I thought it would stack it, but maybe not. This is going to be my inventory checker right here. For now, let's pretend that's an inventory checker, because I forgot to make one. Thought I made everything I need. And you're just going to go straight down to this guy. And the inventory checker is going to be brown once there's a connection there. I think I can force one. Yeah, I can. Cool. And then over here, you are going to be a force connection on blue. Cool. Just like this one was. Nice. Now we're going to want to reroute these guys. We might wind up completely moving them, but we'll see. And what we're going to instead have is pressurized fluid conduits that kind of go. That's fine. Into here. Cool. So that's that. Then you are checking for crystallized oil. So let's do this. How did Lapis get in there? I don't even know how that happened. Let's make our inventory checker real quick, and then we're gonna build our redstone circuit. And then we're going to automate making more of these empowered canola seeds, because we're going to want a stack of them, at least to get started. So inventory checker, that guy, right? So machine base, just need 3 gold nuggets, some stone, a redstone comparator. Check. 6 of you. One of these dudes. Go in here. One of you. I think I've got redstone torches on me. I do. One of you. One of you. And there you go. Inventory checker. So I'm actually going to swap this, in case you guys didn't pick up on that little fact. I'm switching it up, so that we're gonna have the one that I already built, which is the crystallized oil, is gonna be on the left side. Cool. There we go. Let's just have you check for, so you're gonna be crystallized oil seeds, okay? You're gonna check for one of these to exist. So as long as you have a crystallized oil seed, you'll be good, right? We're going to take these out of here. You're going to actually check for those guys now, empowered canola seeds, okay? Which means you're not good. You can see it down there. You're with crystallized now. It's match meta, match or dictionary. Ah, there we go. Or don't, yeah, there we go. Match metadata. These must be the same block with metadata on them. Let's see. F3H. This is 4198/24, and this is 4198/23. So yes, if you want to compare the difference between these and these, you have to compare metadata. See? So we should tell this guy to match metadata as well. Okay. We haven't set up the circuit yet, but so crystallized will go here. Oil will come in here. And then what we'll do is on the east side, we're going to extract, always active. On the west side, we're going to insert. Cool. And then we'll do the same thing here. Now, you're going to look for not crystallized oil. You're going to actually look for the other stuff. So let's, for now, let's set you to cobble. Cool. So you won't be happy until there's cobble there. And then we're going to change it once we have the proper oil there. So let's start off. One more thing we're going to want to do then is set these guys up, right? So I could have my tiny redstone. I have these, and I have one of these ender pulsars that we're going to want. So basically, it's going to be straight from the bottom, and then torches on the left and right side. And then we're going to want our screwdriver here. So in case you guys had trouble following along with what I made last time, boop, boop, boop. So you're going to read from all three sides. And then these guys are going to be torches that you're reading from. And then we're going to have an Ender Pulsar here that you're reading from. That was set to what? 30 seconds? Or 3 seconds, I mean? So 60 ticks. Remember, that's 3 seconds. Hold shift to change that, by the way. And that's all she wrote, right? You should be groovy now, I believe. So, provided that I didn't derp anything up, this should 100% be ready to roll. Okay, so let's do this. It's getting dark out. Let's start compressing our oil in a second. I want to sleep through the night. And then if everything's set up properly, we should have in the last, 5 minutes? I don't even know, I'd have to look. Duplicated what we did the other episode, minus all the explanations and prep stuff. And because I had a nice little system to look at next to me to compare to. So canola seeds go in. What we should start seeing is oil making its way down here into this dude. Yes. Now you're set to measure 15%, so you should not deploy until we get to the 15% mark. And then at that point, this doesn't really have to be here, you'll deploy your oil and you'll drop your crystallized seed. And then we're going to change this. Okay, to match the proper oil. Why did you not deploy? Why are you not deploying? Oh, because I forgot to connect that. Haha. Okay. Let's take these out. Let's do something to make you really unhappy. No, that's fine. As long as there's nothing. I forgot to hook this up. I'm like, why didn't it work? Oh, right, because I'm a derp. And I derp stuff up. So this should be a pulse on blue. So you're going to actually be configured to be disabled. And you're going to be on the up blue signal. Cool. So if we put, let's do, and then set your current block to crystallized oil. So that's how you should be knowing that you're good. And then this needs to be set to, on the north side, a strong signal. Right? Cool. And then you've got oil in you, but the crystallized oil is inside the fluid still, so we have to remove that. So that should be good. This is not going to deploy currently because there's no seeds in the dropper. Now, did we already get all of our liquid out of those canola oils? Like, are we done with those? Oh, you're out of power. Okay, well, that makes perfect sense. That makes all the sense in the world, actually. So let's do this. Let's remove you. Now, you're in pulse mode. I'm going to want to get those liquids out. I think the best way to do that is to, if break and replace hopefully works. Nope. So here's what we're going to have to do. We will have to get a tank. To suck that liquid up. I might have what I need for a tank. If I were to get some glass, I might have some sitting around, but I might not. Can you please be in furnace mode? Thank you. Zoinks. You guys, I need bars, and then we're going to need a tank. Thank you. Sort those bad boys away. This tank will use to just suck up that oil, and then we'll probably just void it or something. It's the easiest way that I could think of to pick that stuff up. Right? Hello. You, sir, seem to not want to do what I want you to do. Can I not pull oil out of the fluid placer? Interesting. Okay. Let's find another method to clear this inventory, actually. Huh. Okay. Back in a minute. Gotta come up with a creative solution to this. So I hate that this was my solution to this, but I'm making a new fluid blazer. I will have to figure out a way to get that liquid out of there later. I have no idea. I just want to make sure that you're in redstone mode before I place you down. Okay. So let's go put this down there. The trials and tribulations of modded Minecraft. All right, so you should now get your crystallized oil. You're not placing because you don't have a little bit more than a bucket's worth. Also, we don't have any empowered seeds in here, right? So if I place another crystallized seed in here, this should be allowed to run once. Boom, picks it up. Now we've got two buckets worth, and we don't have any items in here, but we're fulfilling our bucket amount need. We are now, cool, okay. So that's cool. So now we place empowered canola here, and within 3 seconds it should, nice. Now we're gonna set to current block, which is gonna pick it up and send it upstairs. How much RF a tick do we get for that? Spoiler alert, it's a lot. Except for the fact that you guys all have crystallized oil in you, which is not. Luckily, these can be cleared by doing this. So maybe I'll just report that it's unclearable. So you probably got all the oil, but look at that, 350 RF a tick. That's a lot of RF. So I did some testing in a single player world, and I think you get like 100,000 for basic oil. You get like double that. So like, no, it's not that. It's like 200, 400, and like 750. So I think a bucket of empowered oil will get you like 750,000 RF total. How cool is that? So let's now make some hoppers, or we could make an even nicer automation system. Let's automate this in a way that's planned to work in the future. How's that? Not just with hoppers that are ugly. We're gonna use item conduits, boom. And what we're gonna do with item conduits is basically say, we're gonna whitelist them in a certain way. So I don't have any more pulsating. If I can do 9, 1, 2, 3, I don't think 9's gonna fit. Right, because it needs to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, no. Item conduits is not going to work unless I make more of them, which I can absolutely do, but it means using up one of the ender pearls that I really wanted to take to find the end, which is a bummer for me, not for you guys, for me. So if we didn't do item conduits, I really think item conduits is the way to go with this thing. So let's do item conduits. Okay? Let's do item conduits. Alloys. That is not iron, that is electrical steel. I wanted iron, please. Cool. Conduit binding. Where's conduit binder? I know I have some. There it is. By the time I got that, you were done. I can't. There's nothing I can do to hang on to ender pearls. I'm like, I'm gonna hold on to these ender pearls. I'm not gonna use them. And then an opportunity, like, we really need to get automation with ender pearls going. Like, super duper a heck of a lot. We need to get more ender pearls. Cool. So what if we placed an input chest, which is what I wanted to make real quick. Do I have enough? I do. So let's call this bad boy an input chest. Okay. It's about time that we cleared out a little bit more space down here. This will do, right? So items will be extracted from here. And they will be inserted into the appropriate inventories, okay? So we can just run this piping right along here, and that should be cool. Okay, let's... So So those are all going to be set to insert, but we probably want to make filters for those so that we can specify which items are allowed to go into them. Let's put this on items only mode so we can see the item conduits only and we know exactly where we placed them. Good. Cool. Okay. Now the only thing I need is a way out of here. So that'll work. So then we just need filters. Basic item filters should do for now, provided that I have the paper. I've been using rice for paper, haven't I? Isn't that what I was using for paper? Yeah, that's why I didn't have sugarcane. Remember I said, like, last episode, I'm like, oh, you know what? I never got sugarcane. Now I know why. To do harvest rice, or add it to the farm, or something. Wood, good. Does this recipe exist? Yeah, it totally does. Awesome. So filter, hopper, check, right? There's also the advanced item hopper, which requires a Z-Logic controller. This gives you more things that you can do. But I'd rather just go regular hoppers or filters right now. So we're gonna filter on the insert sides and we're gonna specify what items are allowed to be inserted. Cool. So you will be insert whitelist canola seed, okay? Over here, we're going to have, just realized I need five. Yeah. Will be whitelist crystallized seeds. Okay. And then I'm going to probably set that to also extract. So let's do two more filters. Okay. Because we're going to want to filter what's allowed to be extracted as well. So you are inserting only canola seeds. You are currently inserting in and out. Insert crystallized seeds. Once I get the proper item, I will configure the extract, which will be always active. And we're going to put our, well, I won't have it not active yet, but you get the idea. Cool. You will be insert whitelist canola seeds. And as we decide to automate the crafting of other things, this will be relatively straightforward, right? We just add the item to the whitelist on what's allowed to go in there. So if we wanted to, you know, auto craft the lapis stuff that we needed, right, for the greenhouse class, right, we would just come over here and say, you know, three of these can whitelist prismarine, one of them can whitelist cyan dye, and the center one whitelist palus crystallis block, right? And then we've got automation. Which is what we want, right? So you insert canola seeds. Cool. So this is future proof-ish. We are limited to five recipes that we can teach the system. We can expand that to 10 if we do the advanced things, right? So in theory, this should be good. Now you should be in and out. You're gonna insert, or you're gonna insert on brown, and you're gonna extract on green, always active. You're gonna extract on brown with a whitelist, and we're going to specify what you're allowed to do. But for now, if I put one of you and one, two, three, four of you, it's running. Cool, right? And then if I whitelist this guy on the extract in powered, so let's do like 16 in a stack. You should be extracting. I don't think I added you to the always active. Can you not extract from the bottom of that? Come on, don't tell me I can't extract from the bottom of that. I'm gonna hate you so much. Extract, channel brown, always active, empowered canola. You should be extracting, and you are, that's why. In, out, insert brown. Nice, it's working. Look, totally working. This one was not set to allow the insert of channel brown, so that was your problem. You guys probably noticed that derp a little bit, right? And you probably were yelling at me because I did not notice the derp. If I wanted this to look a little bit better, I could put a facade here. But I'm going to. Painting machine. Paint it with the floor. Cool. Nice. Conduit facade. We just got our 16 empowered canola. How great is that? Let's sleep through the night so that it's not dark out over there. And now we have, in theory, we fully automated the top tier of what we need to for power gen in oil generation, right? Like, that is cool. That is super cool. Okay. I'm not even kidding when I'm telling you guys. I'm pretty proud of that process. I'm gonna get more canola. So I've got 3 stacks of it now, which is great. And we've got a decent number of seeds as well. I'm actually gonna get all 3 stacks. I'm probably gonna wanna hopper that stuff in. So who wants to make another hopper with me? And at some point, it will be something like this, but in reverse, where we're item interfacing, we're extracting from that chest over there, and then we're hoppering it into the thing. But we'll get there when we get there. For now, did I hear a zombie? I did. Look at all the loot you gave me, Mr. Zombie. Thank you. Okay, so let's put the squeezers in. Okay. So your canola's cooking. Right? We should have a decent amount of oil here. So I'm going to throw a stack of crystallized canola seeds in here. I'm going to throw the 17 empowereds. So let's watch this thing in progress. Nice. Dude. Are you guys seeing this? How cool is this? How awesome. And it fits within a 9x9. Did I mention that? It fits completely, almost perfectly, because it's 3 blocks in length and we have a 7 interior, right? So it's almost perfectly inside that 9x9 space. How cool is this? The answer, my friends, is it's very cool. This I just want to set to disabled because I don't like seeing that there, but it doesn't really affect anything, right? Like, wow, that is awesome. I want you guys to know that we have a large amount of power gen available to us right now. We are currently generating a large amount of power to the point where 350, I actually think that we have a problem. We don't have a powerful enough conduit system to handle the power gen that we're producing. I think we're gonna have to make the next tier of power conduits. We're producing too much power. These things can only handle 640 RF a tick. We just surpassed that. What's up? How's it going? Hope you guys are proud of that, because I am. Powered furnace, take care of these for me, would you? We have to go handle that because we're currently wasting power. So I'm kind of rushing to fix this because that was a bit of a derp on my part. These can handle 5,120 RF a tick. We're not quite there yet. I'm going to set you to never active so that you stop wasting power. This should now stop running in theory. Okay, I don't know why you are not stopping, but we're going to make these enhanced energy conduits. Let's just run these here for now until I make more. So you are set to now active with signal. You should be able to extract this power mightily. We're not producing more than 1,000, right? Yes. I need another tier of capacitor bank. Haha. All right, so let's do... You come with me, sir. So you guys should stop running at this point because you have nowhere to send your power. Okay, let's get the next tier. Is that cool with you guys? I think that's cool with you. I hope it's cool with you because that's what we're doing. Enhanced, get a little bit more of you. Where'd the capacitor bank go? Didn't I pick it up? Did it fall? Might have fallen. Yep. Totally fell. Wow. Power just went through the roof, guys. I mean, it's not too crazy of an amount of power, if I'm being honest. It's not, like, completely insane, but it's a good amount. So to make this the next tier of capacitor bank, we can make another tier one. Is that our only option? Okay, that works. And a double layer capacitor and some more energetic alloys. So we're going to need... Let's get a dozen of these. Doot, doot, doot. And let's get ourselves another tier one capacitor, I think. So in order to make this, we're going to want actually 6 capacitors. And so we're going to want... Do we have any coal dust? We totally do. Awesome. Good deal. We've already got 3, so let's get 3 more. Or, you know, let's get this. And 4 of you and a bunch of redstone. Nice. So there's my next capacitor bank. And then 2 of these should be sufficient to make a second tier capacitor, aka the double layer. Okay. We can put you away. This hat can go away because I have that for some reason in my inventory. Boo. I should probably upgrade this chest or do something about it at some point. You are 6, so now we can probably craft you guys. This is nice. A, it carried over the RF that it had in it, and B, it can now accept 5,000 RF a tick. Sweet. So that means we have no problem transferring the 5,000 RF a tick that we're getting in there. We have a net gain of currently 269 because we're transmitting a bunch via lasers. There is a higher tier capacitor laser, by the way. That can do more. These guys are currently capable of doing, I want to say, 1,000. The next advanced energy laser relay just requires some empowereds and some... That's actually really easy to upgrade. And 10,000 RF a tick instead of 1,000. Remember, though, that it splits. So, like, this laser up here is going in 2 different directions. So currently it's doing 1,000 up, 500 that way, 500 that way. It's going to be a little different in a minute, but that's cool. So I guess we're, like, empowering some capacitors somewhere. But overall, we're doing really good on power gen. Yeah. I'm excited. Are you guys excited? Because I am. All right. Let's, I did have a few more of these coming my way. I want to replace all the doohickeys that were down here. Okay, so let's shovel up this floor, because I'm pretty sure that's gonna help me. Okay. And then you tap into here and here, and you guys should start draining again. Beautiful. So again, awesome. Super duper awesome. Are you still configured with the... Okay, you're not, but active with signal. So now you're getting a redstone signal. We're producing like right around 1,000 RF a tick, which is awesome. It's like 1050, right, is what we're making? Yeah. You guys tell I'm a little bit hyped about this? I'm hyped because it was so easy to do, realistically. Like, making this all do the things that it's doing right now was really relatively easy, which to me is great, right? So I wouldn't mind getting another set of you. So we're gonna do... ...16 in a stack. Let's do another 16 in a stack. Cool. So that'll run and do a bunch of empowering. These guys can be sorted for the time being. Let's go see what our canola seed situation looks like outside. So you're actually doing quite well. Yay, particle effects. Let's get another, like, half stack of these guys. Boom. Laser them. Hey, I said laser. At some point, we'll make this both better and prettier and easier. But for now, we're cool. Dude, that is great. Look at that. Beautiful automation. And from what I gather, we are quite at the wrapping up point. So I'm going to wrap up now. We're going to say Darryl20 signing off. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. Automated the Actually Editions stand and empower system today and upgraded our canola system to do not crystallized oil, but empowered oil. And we will always be running off empowered oil. We're producing way more seeds at the moment than we are canola beans. So the fact that we've, you know, got this all hooked up and running is pretty awesome in my opinion. We are now at 5 million RF stored. That is cool. Well, close to it at least. I'm going to put just a few more of these in here, and I'm going to make sure that there's enough of these in here so that this thing can continue to run. Cool. Beautiful. And that should last us quite a while. So now all we really need to do to fully automate this whole system is get the canola seeds over there, or the canola over there, and then at some point get from the seeds to having crystallized in canola on a 1-to-4 ratio going. For now, Darryl20 signing off. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. We'll probably work on that sometime in the future. Again, I need to get more ender pearls, so we're going to start looking at doing that super duper soon. Maybe next episode we'll try and get to the end with the one ender pearl that I have left. I might have a second that's grown over here by now, but we'll see right now. So Darryl20 signing off. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. Still not a seed there. All right, take it easy, guys.